call this meeting of the Salinas Public Arts Commission to order. Good evening, everyone. This meeting is being conducted consistent with State of California Executive Order N-2920, dated March 17, 2020, regarding the COVID-19 pandemic. The public may view the meeting on television and/or online and may participate in person in the city council chamber. And now I'd like to ask everybody to join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic of which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, Tricia, would you lead us in roll call, please?
Chair Commissioner Bailey.
Here.
Commissioner Gonzalez.
Here.
Commissioner Marr. Commissioner House.
Here.
Commissioner Cortez. Commissioner Saldivar.
Here.
Commissioner Tamayo. Okay.
Okay, thank you. And we have an introduction by Kristen Lindquist, please.
Yes, thank you, Chair and members of the Commission. I'm actually going to call Jose Ariola, our Community Safety Administrator, up to introduce his new staff. And I think you'll be pleased to learn of some of the things she'll be involved in.
Good afternoon. Jose Arriola, Community Safety Administrator, and one of my duties is to get to support the Public Art Commission, which I'm very happy and proud to do. We've added some capacity, which I'm really excited about, to support the division and the many things we do, including public art and the Public Art Commission implementation of the Public Art Master Plan. With the hire of our new admin analyst, Jessica Bardwaj, Jessica has been with the city before in a part-time capacity and now is with us full-time through this position. We're excited to add her, and she's been with us now a few months. She's actually been assisting in the development of what I'll present to you today, and so I'll talk a little bit about that. But Jessica, would you like to get up and say hello to the commission?
Good evening, commissioners. My name is Jessica Barwaj. I'm the administrative analyst for the Community Safety Division, specifically with the Library and Community Services Department. A little bit about me is that I'm a longtime resident of the Monterey County. I grew up in Gonzales. I went to high school here in Salinas and did my undergrad at CSUMB in business administration. And I recently graduated with my master's of business administration with the University of Phoenix. I provide administrative and clerical support to the division, and I'm very honored to be a part of the team. I'm super excited. I got lucky to finish my master's and get hired full-time immediately, and I look forward to having a positive impact in the community here and to have a part in public art. Thank you.
Thank you.
Jessica, welcome. We are so happy to have such a qualified person in this position. We all look forward to working with you too, so congratulations to the team. It's wonderful news. Public comment procedures. If you wish to make a general public comment or comment on a specific agenda item, you are encouraged to attend the Public Arts Commission meeting in person. Public comment may also be submitted via email at patricia.meraz, it's spelled M-E-R-A-Z, at ci.salinas.ca.us, and will be entered into the record. Public comments generally are limited to 2 minutes per speaker, and as chair, I'll make further limit the time for public comments depending on the agenda schedule. So if there's anybody here who has public comment you'd like to make, this is the time to do it. Was there any public comment that was submitted? Okay. Seeing none, we'll move along to the agenda items. We have elections for consideration of chair and vice chair. So first, I'd like to ask if there are any nominations for chair and vice chair. Go ahead. Please speak up.
Yes, I'd like to nominate for chair, Ms. Bernice House.
Okay, Bernice House has been nominated for the chair. Great. And anybody else? for chair.
Can you nominate yourself?
I believe you can nominate yourself.
Yeah, I'd like to nominate myself if there's any position that needs to be filled for chair or vice chair.
Okay, so we also need a vice chair. So is that something you'd be interested in?
Sure, either or.
Okay.
Anything that helps support our mission, you know?
Great.
So I think you'll need to see if there's a second on the original motion of Commissioner House as chair.
Okay, so let's take that first. So do we have a second for Commissioner House as chair?
I'll second it.
Okay, great. So let's call for the vote for the chair position for Commissioner House.
Commissioner Bailey?
Aye.
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Aye.
Commissioner House?
Aye.
Commissioner Saldivar?
Aye.
And Commissioner Tamayo?
Did I sit in the wrong place? I'm sorry. Oh. Cortez,
sorry.
It's
wrong
okay.
One.
Aye. Sorry.
There you go.
Okay, aye. Thank you.
You got that vote. Okay, very good. So moving on to the nomination for the vice chair. So Commissioner Cortez's name has been read for the vice chair. Do I have a second?
I would like to second.
Okay, thank you. We have a second. So let's call for the vote, please.
Commissioner Bailey?
Aye.
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Aye.
Commissioner House?
Yes.
Commissioner Saldivar?
Aye.
And Commissioner Cortez?
Aye.
Motion passed.
Congratulations. We have a new chair and vice chair. So congratulations to both of you. We look forward to working with you in those positions. And that will begin next meeting.
And I think you could, I believe Commissioner House now as chair can take over from this meeting.
Next meeting is fine.
Okay.
Okay. It was a surprise. Thank you.
Okay. All right. So now we're going to look at the quarterly meeting schedule for the fiscal year 2022-23. So you see we have a meeting schedule that has been presented. I don't see it on this agenda, but it was sent to us. Maybe it's in here.
So yes, on the agenda, it does list November 14th?
Yep, November 14th, February 27th, right? And May 15th, 2023. So any comments or questions about those dates and times?
No, not at the moment.
Okay. So if not, then I would just ask for a motion, if somebody wanted to motion to approve.
I motion to approve the agenda for the quarterly meeting schedule.
Okay, very good. And do I have a second? Okay. Did you get that? Okay, very good. So we'll call for the vote.
Commissioner Bailey?
Aye.
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Aye.
Commissioner House?
Yes.
Commissioner Saldivar?
Aye.
Commissioner Cortez?
Aye.
Motion passed.
Thank you. So now to the business of approving the minutes from February 28th, 2022. I know that's a while back, but hopefully you've had a chance to review the minutes. And if anybody would like to make a motion to approve, or if you have any comments or questions you'd like to make regarding the minutes.
What was the minutes about? I'm sorry.
So it was the summary of our last meeting in February. Okay, so that would exclude you from being able to vote about them.
Yeah, I was not here either.
Yeah.
So this has come up previously, and we're able to move it forward based on those that are willing to vote tonight, so we don't have to table this for a future meeting. Correct, Trish?
So Bernice, is that something you could lead a motion on? Yeah.
Motion to approve.
Okay. And is there a second? I don't know if there was anybody else but me there. Were you at that last meeting? Yeah, if you could second then.
I second.
Okay. And then we will just call for the vote, please.
Commissioner Bailey?
Aye.
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Aye.
Commissioner House?
Yes.
Commissioner Saldivar?
Aye.
Commissioner Cortez?
Aye.
Thank you. Motion passed.
Okay, and then we're on to the administrative report about public art annual plan implementation.
Hello again, and good evening, commissioners. First, I just want to thank you for your time and attention today. As I said before, my name is Jose Arriola, Community Safety Administrator in the Library and Community Services Department. And part of my duties is to support the implementation of the Public Art Plan and the Public Art Commission. And so I have a great update for you guys today. At the March 22nd City Council meeting, there was unanimous approval of our annual plan for this fiscal year 23, authorizing $6,000 in spending. If you recall from our planning and the plan we presented to this commission that you all approved, $5,000 of that monies would go to support public art events, so events that promote public art. And so we would do that in two potential grants of $2,500, or a maximum of $2,500. And that's a matching grant, and in-kind grants are allowed. And $1,000 of the $6,000 would go to help promote the Public Art Commission, Public Art Commission vacancies, the availability of this grant, and so we would invest some of that money to help with promotion and visibility of the commission and the grant opportunities available. We have an aggressive timeline because this all has to happen within a fiscal year. We have a draft of the RFP ready to go to our LCS director for review. We hope to have a final draft of that by the 25th and go live on the 26th with that opportunity to the public. We're also working on the graphics to promote that opportunity. We could use some of the funds to improve promotion in social media, in other doing print graphics if we'd like. There are a variety of different things we can do to promote this opportunity and make sure we get the money out the door and supporting public arts in Salinas. And then we would begin aggressive publicity of that grant opportunity later this month. Now, as I mentioned before, Jessica Bardwaj, who is now part of the team, will help support this effort, and has already been working on, has already helped with the draft of the plan, and has already developed some graphics for the plan that we're currently refining. And so we're very excited to have that added. So it's added capacity, so it's less likely things will fall as other priorities, always come to us at our desk, but with more people, we can get more done.
I had a question about the graphic. Do I wait for questions later?
Just a minute. Yeah, I'm just about done, and then we can get to questions. And this is an example of something we've put out before when we were looking to fill vacant commissioner seats for the Public Arts Commission. Just an example of some of the stuff we've done in the past. And the next step, and there will be action on this item, is to select a subcommittee of the commission for grant selection. And so the way we're writing the RFP, it's not necessarily gonna be a sort of start and end date or a deadline. It'll be open, and we'll accept applications as they come and review them. And if they meet the criteria and this committee decides that it's eligible for funding, then we will fund it. In that way, we make it as available as possible to people who are ready to implement. So that'll be something we do tonight. I think we need at least two or three commissioners to be on a committee like this. And we'll give the next update at the next commission meeting on the 14th. Hopefully by then we've already awarded a couple of these grants, or at least one of them, and are able to give you an update as where we are with spending. And then we can now go to questions. Thank you.
My question was regarding the graphic. I work doing a lot of art projects here and mostly some personal art projects. And one of the things that I noticed is if you get an artist that's a local artist to do the graphic, that helps spread the word amongst the artistic community. Like if they're developing like some sort of design or logo, there's a lot of artists in the community that do that type of work. People that are starting off or people that are already kind of more in the field. And that also opens up the door to other artistic minds or people that are more like-minded that want to support the arts. And even if some person's just working on the design, they show it to a cousin, they show it to a friend, and the word gets around through that even. So just wondering if there's local artists involved in the design and in the drawing of the logo or graphic.
Commissioner Cortez, I appreciate the suggestion. Thank you. And it's something we could definitely explore.
Are any other questions?
I do. Jose, thank you for your presentation. Thank you. I had questions regarding the about the new funding that the Public Arts Commission is receiving. And is that is there anything that could match that? Is there other opportunities for
to match the $6,000?
Yeah.
I haven't considered that using the allocation of that funding for another matching grant. I suppose it's a possibility, but it's not something I looked into or spoke with the city attorney about. Director Lundquist, is there something you wanted to add?
Yeah, I mean, I think some of you may have heard there's been asked by various council members to allocate additional funding for public arts, and that may be something that council does. They have not done so yet, but I believe it's being considered as part of the available fund balance that's coming up, I believe, for consideration in September. So in the event that council does take that action and allocates additional funding, then we'll be coming back to the commission to talk about how do we administer that funding, whatever that amount may be.
Thank you.
That's a great suggestion for the matching, Juan Carlos.
That'll be something Jessica and I can research.
Can you speak just a little bit to the Grant Selection Committee, what the roles and responsibilities will be of that group, how often they would meet, so as people kind of raise their hand for that, they know what they're raising their hands to do?
So the committee would need to meet on an as-needed basis, because the plan is not to put required deadlines, but to make it open and ongoing until the money is spent. I'm not sure what the response will be. Though well publicized, it is for events, and you know, events don't happen as very often. They happen, but it would require somebody either creating an event or having one and saying, hey, this is a good opportunity to help fund the event. And so hopefully we get in the right people's ears. And so the idea would be that as we got applications, we would review them as staff first to make sure they meet the minimum requirements, and then bring it to the committee for further review and make a recommendation, say, we believe this is a application that could work for funding. And so I imagine it wouldn't be, we'd likely meet virtually so as to not reduce travel. And I could imagine the meetings being rather short, depending, again, on the amount of applications we were receiving at any one time.
Would you say like one hour meetings, maybe?
Yeah. And if they were coming in, you know, we try to maybe get them in and then wait a couple weeks, and so we wouldn't do more than one a month if, you know, if we're getting them constantly. But, you know, there are only, it is only $5,000, so if we're getting them at that pace, it would happen within a couple months and we'd probably be done.
I had a question. It has to do with the funds also, but is there any type of, or are we allowed to try to reach out to get some type of fundraising going with like local entities as the Public Arts Commission? Like if we wanted to raise that pot of $6,000, maybe not this fiscal year, but maybe next fiscal year, or just any type of fundraising that we're allowed to do or to ask for organizations or businesses in the community?
As a commission, is that what you're asking, to raise funds as a Public Arts Commission?
Yeah, I know it sounds weird because it's like the city of Salinas, like asking, you know, but I mean, it's always worth a try, I always say.
I would say just to reach general funds, that may be an issue. It'd be something I'd talk with the director or the city attorney about, because the commission is in itself an entity that could receive funds, I don't believe. However, if there were a specific project in mind and we were raising matching funds maybe for a project, I could see how we could maybe make that work. But just to have a general balance around, that could raise some fiscal issues. But I'd have to look into it. I wouldn't know it. Director Lundquist, anything you want to add?
I think that's accurate, but I think there's things that we can consider moving forward. I know in the past we've talked about potentially writing grants. But we also want to be cognizant that many of you are involved in the arts, right? And so we don't want to generate a competitive application against another local art group, right?
Yes.
So we've had those considerations in the past. But I think we could continue to talk that through. I think it'll be interesting to see what action council takes in terms of potentially allocating additional funds. And depending on where that goes, we could take that conversation up again as we plan for the next public art update, which is due by April. So I think those are ongoing conversations.
Great, thank you so much.
Yes, I just have maybe like a couple of comments, but I was thinking about the idea of fundraising. I think the idea of exploring grants, and I know most of us are artists and probably connected to other arts organizations, but what I was contemplating in the past when it comes to grants, it was that there were grants out there that the city could apply with a cohort or a group of other entities in the city that are arts related, and that there could be opportunity to strengthen that fabric that's already there, and also implementing like arts that they are doing, you know, in other areas where there's art is missing. And then another thing that I thought about your presentation was about whether. I don't know, part of maybe it's a long process, but part of also like looking around in the city what other entities are also interested in doing public art or have initiatives already ongoing, and that how are we having a bigger conversation, you know, so that way maybe part of the art commission can be part of that conversation, so that way there's awareness of, you know, like the Alisal district, you know, or something like that, you know, maybe a new art district, you know, in the Alisal or something like that, or in downtown Salinas, I don't know. But it's like, but these conversations like can be gathered, like if we know maybe someone in this city that is constantly getting this type of information, you know, like from Hartnell, from other schools, I don't know. There's different entities right now that might be interested in doing art related, but they don't have maybe public the whole funding. There's a lot of artists who are not who are members of organizations, but they're not per se nonprofits. They are like an incubation, you know, or they are artists being residents or in house, you know, in different arts communities. And I see that I seen grants out there where, but I don't know if it was specifically where the city could apply, But I know it was when other entities can apply together as a group, or just one entity, that one that has more opportunity of the administrating this, and then forming those MOUs or those agreements with the city, so that way, seeing ways that it could work in the future. I think that's what we were talking about. And the idea of fundraising, you know, Carlos, I think it's a great idea, but I think it's like, it takes a long time to coordinate something, you know, that people also could not just say that, like, I'm gonna go and give this money, but they're actually gonna see something that, you know? So I think it'll be good to try with the communities that we already know, that we are involved, right?
Yeah, solidifying the relationships, because there's a lot of, like Juan Carlos said, there's a lot of arts organizations, and helping solidify those and partnering would be like the best.
Thank you.
Okay, are there any other questions or comments?
Actually, I do, and I almost forgot. I know Klaus Oldenburg just passed away, and the artist that created the three hats in the three stages, and I know that there's efforts in Harnell College, like they're gonna do something in their gallery, but I know there's a big opportunity to also continue having that conversation that he brought to Salinas, right, about the public art. And if you in the near future, you would like to do something like that, I can support it. Something that can fundraise, you know, for what we're doing, and it can be part of what he's done.
Okay. I didn't know he had passed away. Yeah. Okay, so I think now we have the opportunity to elect those three people who would sit on the selection, the grant selection subcommittee. So do I have anyone who is interested in being on that subcommittee?
I can't.
JC?
Yeah, me too.
Bernice?
Okay. I can do it also.
Okay. Okay,
great, thank you.
Three. Thank you very much. Okay. So now we're going to move on to the commissioner's report. And so this is anything that a commissioner might have to report on. Bernice, can I turn it to you and ask that you include in your comments something about the Caltrans mural project?
Yeah.
Yeah, perfect. Thank you.
Yeah, I was part of the group that were able to invite to have the request for the arts under the bridge on Market Street, Alisal and Sanborn. And we received 12 applications, and then we invited six, and this project was with the California
Caltrans.
With Caltrans, so they are paying the city receive funds, and all the artists were being paid to submit their requests, their proposals, and it was very hard because many we wanted to support our local artists, and we received applications from out of town, out of state, and it was a little bit disappointed that our local artists needed more support, meaning they were not, there are so many regulations working with the transportation office, like they need to have an insurance, they need to have a certification, they need to have, there's a big process, and since our local artists didn't have the opportunity yet, it was a good learning process, and I was so happy to see that the director, she was very nice and very generous, that when we were doing the selection, she was thinking about that and how to support them in the future. So it was, even though it was the first one, I think a big scale since, I don't know if I'm wrong or not, but since I moved here almost more than a decade ago, this is the first time where I saw our local artists being in a real process, meaning exactly everything that they need to know, like all the protocols, all the insurance, and how much, what kind of paint, and how all the chemicals, all the science about painting. So it was a lot of fun and a lot of learning. So the Arts Council from Monterey County was coordinating this effort, but yeah, so as we were talking, I was listening, you know, for planning for plan as a commissioner. I would like to see a program that can support our local artists in the business part, so they can do, they can submit their proposals to the city. They can have a contract with our city. They can know how to submit a contract. And I know as the arts we are the arts commission, but if we invite public works and if we work the business section, maybe the three of us can help our local artists. Maybe we can create a program for
even
them to support.
Partnering with other organizations.
I know, I'm just brainstorming right now, but yeah, so the exciting part is like they found their, we found our artists, and it's going to be beautiful. Everybody involved in the selection of the artists that will be doing the murals under the bridge were high qualified Salinas locals, and I think they're going to present their drawings here, and so yeah, so it's going to be beautiful, and I think I feel very honored to be with everybody that was part of that panel. So we were considering everything, all the surveys, our constituents, what people wanted, all the surveys that we did, and all the master plans in the city, the Salinas plan, the recreation plan. So we were listening all the feedbacks we received from our citizens of Salinas. So yeah, it's going to be nice. I'm very excited, and I can't wait for you guys to look at it. And yes, it's going to be nice. And we did select local artists, newcomers, like young people that did this, meaning like there's a collaborative of six young artists, and they're local. So it's going to be great. So yeah, I hope that you guys had the picture, and they're going to come back here and show us their marquee picture. Thank you.
Okay, we can just go down this way. So, JC, do you want to share anything?
Sure. Thank you, Bernice. I'm so excited to see the artists and their work. Congratulations. I only have like a few announcements. I have an Urban Arts Collaborative here and in Chinatown. We have a black and white exhibit by three local artists. One of them is from Honduras, and he grew up in Salinas. And another artist is from the LGBT community, and another a lady from Mexico. And so they'll display the artwork in our gallery, and it'll be open on Tuesdays and Wednesdays from 4:30 to 6:30. And we're gonna have another opening this week, but everything is on Instagram or Facebook. And I also have, I'm teaching a class myself on creative inquiry for artists of all mediums, and I have a limited space of 15. And they just have to have some sort of art experience. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
You don't have anything. Okay. I have a couple things. We just, at the Monterey Jazz Festival, just completed our Monterey Jazz Festival Regional All-Star program, where students from all the high schools locally, we had some students from all over Salinas included in those programs, performed at the San Jose Jazz Festival this last weekend. And I just want to let everybody know auditions for that program will open up in October, and we want all the students from every band program in Salinas to come out and audition. The auditions are open to everybody, and they're free and online, and we'd love to see more students from Salinas participating in that. And then, of course, I just want to make sure everybody knows the Monterey Jazz Festival happens this September 23rd through the 25th. This year, we're actually opening up a program at CSUMB to open the whole festival. It's on the 22nd, and it's free to the community, and everybody is welcome, and it'll focus on national students who are coming from all over the country who are going to perform for us. So students from Morgan State University, Texas State University, both HBCUs, large HBCUs, and then students from our national bands and our national vocal ensembles. We have a gospel choirs coming out. It's going to be a phenomenal event on the 22nd at the World Theater from 6 to 8, and all are invited, so we encourage you to participate.
Hi, I want to thank everybody, great announcements, and also for the Overpass project. It's beautiful to hear that there's local artists being involved. I just wanted to talk about that subject, about the Overpass. The same thing about equity in the arts as far as applying. There's a lot of really great artists that are folk artists, but they have never filled out an application that is so big and that has so many words and so many like little restrictions. So I totally second what you said about finding a way to create more equity in applying for arts projects, because there's really great artists and they get, they feel overwhelmed or they feel like they're not enough somehow. Like they feel like, oh, that's not for me. Like those words are too big, and they're great artists and they've experienced this community like no other. So I think maybe if there was a way that we can help create some type of workshops along with some of these opportunities, whether it's us through the commission or even us as independent arts organizations, I would love to like sit down and talk with anybody about that, because I think that's a big part of the arts. Like equity in applying, it could be so scary. People don't go to school because they're afraid to apply to like FAFSA, or they're overwhelmed with getting information. So I could imagine some like young artists scared to try out, or even professional artists that maybe have done private folk work, because folk art is real art, like any other art. So some of those people, they could get overwhelmed for that. So I'm all about equity. If anybody would be interested in talking about that, or helping maybe find some sort of solutions within ourselves, and then maybe bring them up to the bigger group, that would be awesome. I also work with Artist Inc, and we're starting a drawing class. We work with mostly like 10-year-olds all the way up to like 18, kind of just, you know, teenagers and tweenies. So we start every Wednesday right here at Artist Inc at 1 Midtown Lane. I encourage anybody who has any teenagers, pass by, check it out. It's pretty fun. Thank you so much.
Is there any way we could put that on the agenda for our next meeting? It seems to be a concern that we find some focused way to educate the community about how to fill out proposals, how to make it more accessible, and put that as an agenda item.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Well, this is my last meeting as the chair, so I just want to thank you all for the honor of serving in this position. Truly, I think the arts are the things that bridge the community and all the different communities within our local community, and I thank all of you for your service to this community in this way, and look forward to working with our new chair and our new vice chair and our new staff person who will be here to help us. So, Jessica, I'm looking forward to working with you. So thank you so much for that. I think we are ready to adjourn the meeting.
We have a director's report.
We are not ready to adjourn. Kristen, you're on.
We just have a couple of items for you. One, I think, you know, we're always looking for how we can expand our public art. And so we are in the process right now of selecting a construction management and design firm for a variety of park renovations and revitalization projects to include our Prop 68 renovation of Closter Park. And so I just wanted to let you know that we are anticipating a variety of art that is incorporated into that project. So as we get to the point where we have designs and more details, we will certainly bring that to this commission as well. And then I'd like to turn it back to Jose for a couple of updates. I think we recognize the concerns you brought forward in terms of equity and establishing processes that are user-friendly to our public art folks here in this community, our public artists. And I think Jose can speak to a little bit about a trash corral project that we did and where we're at with that. And then also an update on one of the mural projects through the Neighborhood Beautification Grant Project.
Yeah, I was just thinking as you were speaking, Carlos, about how our own applications have been either accessible or not accessible, right? And how easy we make them. And we'll keep that top of mind as we're designing this RFP for this community or public art events grant we're going to put out from the commission, which is the first time we've actually made a funding option available since I've been here, certainly. So I'm excited about that. But just some quick updates for you. The Trash Corral project was something funded out of the LCS budget, and we started it last year. We were able to wrap it up right before the end of the fiscal year, and we got all of them painted. We had to go back and redo a couple, and then there were a couple that were left blank because artists didn't want to do more, ended up not being able to do more than the one or two they had completed, and they had signed up for more. And so we did work with Urban Arts Collective to come in and help finish the ones that were not done. And so they are all complete at this point, and we're going to keep an eye on them and hopefully maintain them as the years wear on them. So check them out. I'm sure you've been in downtown and been down Main Street and started to look at some of them, and really, really neat pieces. There's so many I really enjoy just taking a look at them. Beautiful pieces of art. And then through the Neighborhood Beautification Grant, if you remember when we reported out, there were a number of arts element art applications in this last round. And so Hijos del Sol will begin painting in the next week and a half or so at the Bread Box. We're really excited. That should go up. We did have to extend the timeline on that, but we anticipate it being done here in the next couple of months. So that will give the Bread Box a really vibrant front face to its center, and we're excited about that. And then Main Street Art Gallery completed a mural. Now, they did movable murals, so we're working with our partners in the LSL Vibrancy Plan implementation team to look for homes for these movable murals. But you can see them now if you'd like at the Northridge Mall. You can, if you go there where Rite Aid used to be, and I think it's now like four other stores, Ulta and Oshkosh B'gosh or something, but the old garden center, they actually have all the art there. It's almost like an outdoor gallery. You should go check it out if you get a chance. Main Street Art Gallery has been doing those, and so they've gotten that grant 2 years in a row and now have two of them up. And like I said, we're looking for homes in partnership with the Alta Vibrancy Plan implementation team in community development. And so it takes some time. Public art, there's so many hoops to jump through sometimes. Some of them are our regulations, some are, you know, working with people who own buildings and trying to make sure it works for everybody involved. So we're working our best to get those up. But those are some of the updates I have for you, and I appreciate all your comments today, and I made notes of all of them, and I'll work with our team here to make sure we address them. Thank you.
So it was my dinner bell going off that got me jumping ahead. So apologies to everyone, the most important part at the end. So thank you so much, and we are adjourned.